Hey, my name is Felipe and welcome to my channel. In this tutorial, we will be discussing object detection with YOLO. YOLO is such a powerful and such an amazing object detector, and over the years there have been many different versions of YOLO. So in today's tutorial, we will try to understand why are there so many different versions and which one should you use in your particular project. Let's get started. So regarding all the different versions of YOLO, this is a very quick summary of all the different versions which have been released over the years. So you can see that this is definitely a lot of different versions of YOLO. YOLO V1, YOLO V2, YOLO V3, V4, V5, PP YOLO, scaled YOLO V4, YOLO R, YOLO S, YOLO X, right, and so on. So there has been so many different variants. And the first question we should ask ourselves is, why are there so many different versions, right? This is the elephant in the room, right? This is the elephant in the room. Why are there so many different versions of YOLO? I don't know if it happens to you, but it used to happen to me that I used to ask myself, why are there so many different versions? Why don't we just keep the newest one and we just deprecate everything else, right? I used to ask myself that question. Why don't we just deprecate all the older versions of YOLO and we just use the most recent one? So basically, the chronological order in which they are released doesn't necessarily mean anything. And what I'm trying to say is that each new version of YOLO is not necessarily an improved version of the previous one. This is very important. And also, each new version of YOLO is not necessarily related in any way to the previous one. And this is important because if we don't make this clear right now, it may be a bit confusing. Because if we look at all the different versions of YOLO which have been released, not only we usually order them by the date in which they were released, but also some of these different versions, many of these different versions are numbered. Right, we have YOLO V1, YOLO V2, YOLO V3, V4, and so on. So it could appear that many of these versions of YOLO are somehow related, or that one of them is better than the other. Well, that's not necessarily the case. So let's continue and let's try to figure this out. Why are there so many versions of YOLO? We need to understand it, right? We really want to answer this question. Some versions of YOLO are developed and released by research teams at universities. Okay. Some other versions of YOLO are developed and launched by companies as part of their new product offerings. This is very important because it helps us understand where all these different versions of YOLO come from, right? In some cases, there are teams of researchers at universities who are actively creating and releasing versions of YOLO, and in other cases, there are companies who are creating products, and the different YOLO versions are part of their product offerings. It helps a lot to understand why are there so many versions. So each new version of YOLO is just a novel approach to object detection. It's like asking ourselves why are there so many different brands of coffee in the supermarket, only because there are many different companies who sell coffee, and only because sometimes a company that sells coffee creates different variations of their coffee. So that's the only reason why we go to the supermarket and there are so many different types of coffee. And something similar happens with YOLO. There are many different flavors of YOLO, there are many different variations of YOLO, but it doesn't necessarily mean that the newest version is better than the previous one, and it doesn't necessarily mean that they are in any way connected. In some cases they are somehow related, but not in all cases. So perhaps this helps a bit to understand why are there so many versions of YOLO. Now let's continue. Which YOLO version should you use in your project? This is a very important question. And I think we could look at this question from many different perspectives, but I'm gonna give you a very specific perspective, which I think is going to help most of you. Different versions of YOLO differ in several aspects, right? Including their licensing terms. Most versions of YOLO, most of them, have been released under an open source copyleft license. Either GPL or AGPL, right? An open source copyleft license. which means a copyleft license requires you to license your project under the same terms as the original license. So if you use one of these versions of YOLO which have been released with an open source copyleft license, means that you need to open source your project as well. So we can look at this question from many different perspectives, but I think this particular perspective is going to help many of you, because it all comes down to, are you willing to open source your project? What does it mean to open source a project? This is a very interesting question. I'm glad you ask. So I am obviously not a lawyer, and this is not legal advice and blah, blah, blah. But I'm going to give you a very quick summary of what it means to open source a project from my perspective, which could potentially be wrong. Basically means that every time you distribute your project, your product, your inferences with the object detector, you also need to distribute the source code of your project, of your product, of your application, right? You need to distribute with your source code. You cannot prevent the users to access the source code of your project. And also, users have the right to use, to modify, and to redistribute your source code and everything that has to do with your product. So, the right to use, modify, and redistribute. But something that's very important is that open source doesn't mean that it's free of cost, right? It doesn't necessarily mean that it's free of cost, because there is a misconception that if something is open source, it needs to be free. No, not necessarily. I believe that not necessarily. The thing is that open source sometimes doesn't get very well with commercial products, with commercial projects, because if you're going to distribute the entire source code of your application, your project, everything, and you cannot prevent your users to redistribute everything, then it doesn't get very well with a commercial project, but it doesn't mean you cannot do it, right? It's very important to understand everything that has to do with what does it mean to open source a project, because I believe this is the most important question you should ask yourself when deciding what YOLO version you should use in your project. Are you willing to open source your project? Because if you are not willing to open source your project, I think these are the most important options for you. You can go for either something like Ultralytics version of YOLO, and I'm referring to YOLO V5, YOLO V8, YOLO 11. If you decide to use Ultralytics YOLO, this is a very fast and very accurate object detector. It's also very well maintained. In this case, there is an entire company that's maintaining the product, so it's going to be very well maintained for sure. But the thing is that if you decide to use Ultralytics version of YOLO and you're not willing to open source your project, you will need to purchase an Ultralytics Enterprise license, right? So in this case, this is an option, but this is not going to be free. Now let's explore other options of what version of YOLO you could choose if you're not willing to open source your project. Another option is YOLO X. YOLO X is also very fast and very accurate. I will say it's well maintained. It's well maintained. I mean, there are developers and there are researchers who are maintaining this project, but there's not an entire company that's allocating resources to make sure everything works well. So it's like it's maintained, it's well maintained, but I think it's not so well maintained as this other example, right? So you see what I'm trying to say. And YOLO X is released with an Apache 2.0 license, which is very permissive, and if you use it, you are not obligated to open source your project. So this is a very good option for many of you who are not willing to open source your project. And we also have other options. Another option would be to use Darknet, right? I'm referring to YOLO V1, YOLO V2, V3, and V4, the first four versions of YOLO. The downside of using something like Darknet is that it may be a bit slower. I think in this case, the technology is a bit older, and this is my perspective. I think it may be slower. I think it's reasonable to assume that it may be slower than other more recent versions of YOLO, only because it's a bit older. Perhaps I am wrong, but I think this, in this case, this one may be slower. It's also well maintained, and it's also released with an Apache 2.0 license. And by the way, the story behind Darknet is very interesting. Currently it's being released with an Apache 2.0 license, but originally it had a very a much more permissive licensing terms, and I invite you to take a look at Darknet repository and you're going to see what I mean. I'm going to post the URL to the Darknet repository in the description of this video, so you can just take a look at it by yourself. So these are three options you can consider if you're not willing to open source your project. There are also two additional options, which are YOLO S and YOLO NAS. In the case of YOLO S, I think it's not so well maintained. I have been inspecting the repository. Perhaps I can show you super quickly. This is YOLO S GitHub repository, and you can see that the latest commit was made 3 years ago. They updated the README, and then everything else was last updated 4 years ago. So I would say it's not being actively maintained. It has been released with an MIT license, so far so good, but the it's not being very well maintained. And then the other option is YOLO NAS. Something that I'm a bit unclear regarding YOLO NAS is what is its license. Because if I scroll down, it says the YOLO NAS model is available under an open source license with pre-trained model weights available for non-commercial use on supergradients. It's a bit confusing. I don't understand what's the license. I think the overall architecture and everything is Apache, and then the model weights, the pre-trained model weights specifically, are given with this license. So anyway, but these are two other options which you may explore if you want. But remember, my recommendation for you is to stick with these three, right? Either Ultralytx version of YOLO or YOLOX or Darknet. Now let's continue. What happens if you are willing to open source your project? In that case, you will have many, many options, because scaled YOLO V4, YOLO V5, YOLO V6, YOLO V7, YOLO V8, YOLO V9, YOLO V10, YOLO V11, V12, YOLO R and YOLO World are released with copyleft licenses. So if you're willing to open source your project, oh, you are going to have some fun deciding which one to use, because there are a lot. And I think in this case, it all comes down to how much fight you're willing to take. And I mean, how much fight you're willing to take to set everything up and running, and also to maintain the project in the long term. Perhaps it also depends on your specific use case building this object detector. Many of you, I guess, are trying to build an object detector to use it in a somehow small project, and perhaps you just want to be able to detect objects like once or a few times and that's it. But then many other of you may be working on larger projects, and you may be looking to build a product or something like that, and you want to be able to use the object detector in the long term, right? So it all comes down to how much fight you're willing to take and how well maintained the repository is. In some of these versions of YOLO, you may need to put something like a fight to set everything up and running and to maintain it. A few minutes ago, I showed you the repository of YOLO S, and the latest commit was 3 years ago. So this is only to give you an example how in some cases some projects are not being actively maintained, and that's something you need to consider before using it in your project. And from all these different versions of YOLO you have over here, the versions of YOLO that are more actively maintained are Ultralytx YOLO. YOLO V5, YOLO V8, YOLO 11. So if you are looking, if you are willing to open source your project, perhaps it's reasonable to go with the versions of YOLO that are more actively maintained, which are Ultralytx YOLO. So yeah, this is only my perspective on this problem, and this is actually what I usually do when I'm building an object detector. If I'm willing to open source my project, then some of the versions of Ultralytx YOLO it's just fine because it's like it's very actively maintained, it works very well, so yeah, why not? But if I am not willing to open source my project, it's usually one of these two options, either Ultralytics YOLO or YOLO X. Ultralytics YOLO, I usually recommend it every time I'm working for a client, and the client is like a big company with a lot of resources. I usually recommend them to purchase the Ultralytics Enterprise license because the client has the necessary resources, and by doing so, they make sure that everything is going to be well maintained in the long term and so on, right? I mean, they make sure. You can never make sure of something, obviously, but it's more reasonable to assume that if you have like a company creating something and allocating resources, everything is going to work better, right? I guess. But in those cases in which I'm working for a somehow smaller client, or if I'm working on a personal project for me and I am not willing to open source my project, then YOLO X is a very good solution. It's very fast and very accurate, and actually when I was preparing this tutorial, I tried to train a model with YOLO X just to make sure everything works perfectly and everything was okay and everything was fast and accurate and so on. And let me show you the results. Let me show you this video over here. This is a video I produced with an object detector I trained using YOLO X. I trained this model to detect ducks, and then I just tested the performance on this video over here, and you can see that it performs very well. It's very accurate, very stable. The execution time was very decent as well. It was around 10 milliseconds per frame, if I'm not mistaken. So it's around 100 frames per second. It's a lot. I was using a GPU. I was using a G4DN XLarge instance type in AWS. So yeah, but it was very fast, very accurate, very stable. Everything works just perfectly. So this is only to show you that using something like YOLO X, you have access to a very decent object detector, which has been released with an Apache 2.0 license. So it's a very good option for sure. The only downside is that it may not be so well maintained as, for example, Ultralytics. So yeah, this is going to be all for this video. Let me know in the comments, what do you think about this video? And let me know also what version of YOLO you usually use in your projects. This is going to be all for today, and see you on my next video.